Yeah, you know, I think it does affect our DNA. It's a very deep thing. You know, we have a relationship with the sun in that our DNA is, you know, if we were to put together aggregate length of our entire DNA of the average human, it's 12.5 billion miles of the stuff. Oh. And that matches the length, the radius at which the sun projects its light before it's stopped by interstellar space at its heliosphere. So the magnetic field of the Earth,
yes,
is being pushed against by the magnetic field of the sun, and the magnetic field of interstellar space is pushing against the magnetic field of the sun in total. So we have this as a grouping, as a solar system, we're kind of like this electric dynamo that's in a process of rotation. So as we are rotating, there is this tail, if you will, that narrows down and curlicues out, that's trailing behind our solar system as we dolphin through this galaxy. And every time we hit these light quotients, these solar flares, I think it, you know, like resets the dynamo of the whole energetic of the whole electrical body of the solar system itself. The physics community has found that the star system, or the nebula of Orion,
mm-hmm.
The Orion constellation that we see out in the skies in the winter up here.
Yeah.
The middle star of the three stars of Orion's belt is the Orion Nebula, and they've been looking at this with telescopes for some time, but they finally through spectrography they were able to get the right spectrum for determining H2O, the presence of that, and with their telescopes determined that within the Orion Nebula there was water being produced at a rate of 60 Earth oceans every half hour.
Whoa.
And as well, there's another galaxy that they found with a black hole at the center of it, that in a lower image. It's a graphic rendition of this, where there's water being ejected out of a black hole, just being produced at level, tremendous levels, far beyond the Orion Nebula, of producing water. So what this, this is, to me, it's always been this great mystery. Where did water come from? You know, half the planet is water, you know? So
right.
it appears to be just some stuff that's in space. That's a product of the sun. So a nebula is an exploded sun that's now coalescing back into a organized star system. So, for instance, our sun used to be a nebula, and that coalesced over time and separated all the various elements, and two of those elements being hydrogen and oxygen. Now, this encodement of the bonding sequence that we see in this image shows how the angle of 104.5 degrees at which the hydrogen attaches to the oxygen generate the three primary sacred geometries upon which all form is based. So there's this kind of there's a geometry for life that's carried along with the substance of life, which is water, and it's all activated by the sun. So the sun activates photosynthesis, makes bonds DNA, which is memory encoding, into water, which is substance and form, and then it hangs off of this kind of fabric in space, which is gravity. And I think that's what we're seeing in these Earth ring forms is how gravity coalesces. And it's kind of, not knowing for sure if that's the case, to make sure, you would say, it's the fingerprint of God. It's so what we're looking at with these geometries Is the intelligence of the Creator coming through and manifesting itself on multiple levels?